morning to you. It's Thursday the 19th of January 2017. A really great night of the quiz last night. We had, I think we started off with 10 teams and we finished off with 8. 2 dropped out. One girl and, one lady. One lady and her boyfriend who were about 35. They were as drunk as anything before we even started. And what we do is 4 rounds. 2 rounds of quick. There's a, like a current affairs news type round. There's a theatre round where it's all like musicals and theatre type questions. There's a picture round and there's a music round, right? So on the first round, we finished round 1 and I went to go and collect their answer sheet. It was soaking wet. Well, I don't know, she'd knocked over a glass of wine. And I mean, you could barely decipher what they'd actually written down. You know, I said, well, how many points did you get? And they said 5, and I looked at it, and I thought, how can I tell whether they got 5 points or not? Anyway, they left during the second round. they were so drunk, honestly, the pair of them. And then we lost that. We often do lose a team or two throughout the course of the night, so that's okay, that's all right. But it was a massive queue, and there was a massive team in. I say massive, 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it was a team of 6 in. That's not massive. A team of 6 in. And they were all other Young's Brewery managers. Because the King's Head Theatre Pub, that is a Young's pub. Okay, a Young's pub run by the lovely Ashley. And it was a load of managers in from Young's pubs who won, incidentally. Very clever, I have to say. I didn't detect any cheating. Don't worry. My beady eye was watching them. My BDI was, it was one of them in particular I was watching last night. There was one of them that were very, very clever, I think Ashley said. Now, what was his name? Let's have a look. Where is it? Scotty, apparently. I'm not sure which one Scotty was. But they were very good, actually. They won by about, I think they won by 4 points in total. And when you get a load of managers from other pubs come to your pub, not my pub, obviously, but Ashley's pub, usually they can be a bit of a handful. Do you know what I mean? Very, very, very full of self-importance. Not this lot. They were really nice. I have done do's in places where you get all these managers come from whatever company you're talking about, you know. And they all descend on someone else's pub and they are a real handful and they start mucking about and thinking they are like the best and all that. Not this lot. They were really nice. They sat there and they just joined in the same as everyone else, except one of them who seemed to be on a dating app all night, whose name will not be intimated from, is that the right word? Who will not be iterated from my mouth. No, I cannot reveal that person. All night long, he was on a dating app all the time. Blimmin' cheek. How dare you be on dating apps while I'm doing my quiz? Anyway, so lovely night last night. Hour and 40 minutes to get in, which is okay. Hour and 10 minutes to get home. I know, I stopped at that blimmin' BP garage again on the way home. Oh, I found a cheap petrol station. Yeah, Gulf. It's if you come off the... Let me think. The M25, A30. You come off the A30... Go towards Staines, down, round a roundabout. And there, if you turn left instead of going straight on, there's a Gulf, G-U-L-F, petrol station there. And I noticed the other day, it was £1.15 a litre. This is for the petrol. All right? Now, generally, the price here, certainly the Sainsbury's up the road, is now £1.20. I've seen it for £1.35 on the motorway. Never, ever buy petrol on the motorway. Don't wait. Don't think, oh, I might just get there. Oh, I'm going to have to fill up. You'll pay £1.30-odd. Don't do it. Never try and fill up on the petrol on the motorway. So I come off that Gulf one. And I'm talking to the bloke in there, Asian bloke. And he was telling me it's his own garage. And he has cheap petrol twice a week. I said, oh, what days? He said, well, there's a random day. He said, which is usually Tuesday. And it was Tuesday, wasn't it, the other night? Yep, it was Tuesday. And always on Saturdays. So I'm going to have to keep an eye out for that. That's 5p. That's 5p a litre less than the Sainsbury's up the road. Now, I've noticed, I don't know what's going on at Sainsbury's, but their petrol seems to have become a little bit more expensive now. Actually, in line with the BP one. BP seems to be the dearest always, But Sainsbury's always was a little bit underneath. At the moment, they're running at the same rate as some of the other places. So I shall be keeping an eye out on the golf one. Next time, when will I... Oh, actually, I'll be going past Saturday morning, won't I? Yes. I go past... So Friday night it is. So that's Saturday morning. So I'll be going past Friday night. And then when do I go past it? No, actually, I'll probably be all right until Monday now. And I will be going past... Oh, no, it'd be gone Monday, though. The special offer, won't it? No, Monday becomes Tuesday, doesn't it? No, I'll leave it till Tuesday. But I'll let you know to see if that's true. I mean, he's no reason to lie, but he says he does cheap petrol on Saturdays and a random day of the week, which is normally Tuesday. Hour is a random day of the week, but normally Tuesday. I don't know. So that's happening on the A30, okay? We need to wish Gareth to get better. Gareth is the boyfriend, and they get married this year, of Ashley, who runs a King's Head Theatre bar. He's not well at the moment. I think he's got a bit of sore throat and all that business. So get well, Gareth. Hope you're doing better, my friend, all right? And why haven't you been in to play my quiz recently? I'm most disheartened. And where's Ed? Is Ed not coming anymore? Most disappointed. TV trouble. I'm still having trouble with my television in the bedroom. I've got a 32-inch thing in the bedroom. It's a few years old now, but it seems to be working fine. But recently, I keep getting glitches on some of the channels. Now, there's a little meter. If you go into the menu, you get a meter. And the signal quality and the signal strength do seem to be fine. I can't work out what it is. So I thought I'll see if it's... I've tried a new aerial socket on the wall. I've tried a new aerial lead from the wall to the television. I've now moved a hard disk recorder up into that bedroom to see if it makes any difference having the television come through that and then just into the screen rather than using the tuner on the television. No, it's still doing it. So I'm not quite sure what it is. Now, someone told me that... The 4G signals for telephones can interfere with Freeview. So I've found on Amazon, 15 quid, I've found a 4G filter, which apparently you plug in between the aerial and the telly, and I'll see if that sorts it. It's not all the channels. It's the channels on UHF channel 23, I think it is, which is a lot of the BBC channels, including the one I watch more than everything else, the BBC News 24. Has anyone got experience on any 4G telephone interference on their televisions? Then please do let me know. So I would like to pick your brains on that one. So that should be coming tomorrow or the day after. I'll see that. Try that out and see if that works as well, OK? Science news this morning, boys and girls. Just when you thought it couldn't get any worse, China... The lovely people in China have now revealed sharp sword stealth drone that can carry 2 tons of bombs. Oh, my. I mean, you can just see some kid, can't you, in a Chinese school with a little joystick going like that and watching me, 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 me. Dear, there's no hope for the human race. We keep inventing more and more ways of killing each other. China has revealed a stealth drone dubbed Sharp Sword that could be capable of dropping more than 4,000 pounds of bombs. The unmanned aerial vehicle won second place in China's National Science and Technology Advancement Prizes and is the first non-NATO craft of its kind, according to the people at Popular Science. It said Sharp Sword could enter service as soon as 2019 for use in reconnaissance missions and for tracking foreign warships, and eventually it could be used for combat. You see, they don't even have to send people over anymore. As I said, it'd be a kid in some school with a little joystick who's seen one of these and has copied it, made one himself, because they're clever. They're very clever, these children. Come on. How many of you have had trouble with your computers at home and had to ask your son, daughter, nephew about it? Because you can't fix it yourself. Oh, itchy nose, dear. Because you can't fix it yourself. Yes, well, you can guarantee they'll be doing one of these. Oh, let's get that one. And it's all over. We won't need soldiers. All the soldiers will be out of work soon as well, won't they? No war. I saw something about a warship. Was it a warship or some sort of military ship? That's remote controlled. No one on there. Go for it. Oh, do you I hope they're not like those ships you used to. Do you remember the little ships you used to buy and you put in a pond when you was a little boy or girl, maybe? And you put these ships in a pond and you'd have a joystick, like, and you know, forward, backwards, and this ship would be going in the pond and then suddenly you just lose contact with it. And it would go out of range. And then your dad would have to wade in, you know, with a stick or something, trying to get this boat back because you'd lost it. Oh, that's it. Another one gone. I mean, there are ponds. There are ponds all around the British countryside that are full. Oh, I've just noticed there's some big buds on my orchid over there. Oh, how lovely. I'll move that over here in a minute. This isn't doing too bad, the poinsettia, is it? Hey, look at that. Not doing too bad at all. Just pull up a few more. Yes, all over the country there are ponds full of little shops, little ships with nowhere to go because they've lost contact with their remote controls. Well, I hope that the automatic boats carrying nuclear warheads all over the world with people in various countries on joysticks. Oh, Mr. Putin, I bet he's got a few of those. He's probably got a desk full of little remote control things. Right, let's send one there today. Don't annoy him. Don't annoy Mr. Putin. He will blow you up. I don't believe he's that bad anyway. I think the media, I do think we are told sometimes to hate someone who doesn't need to be hated. I don't believe he's that bad at all, old Putin. I really don't. How can you believe all these news stories all the time? Huh? No, I think he's all right, Mr. Putin. What he needs is a pair of these, you see. I've still got these standing by if I ever want to do my damn hello possums and all that business. Gladioli, that's it. Gladioli Dame Edna Everidge has, doesn't she? Maybe I should have a flower myself, you know, as sort of indicating that flower is something to do with. Like you would associate gladiolis with Dame Edna, wouldn't you? You would associate roses with the lovely Princess Diana. What could you have for me? Eh? Daisies? And what are those, what are those flowers that are supposed to make you wet the bed? The yellow ones? What are they called? I think I should have those ones. And I could put them all up here and you could all wet yourselves while you're watching me. All part of the fun here on United Kingdom Talk it is. Now, how are your council bins doing, eh? Getting a little bit fed up? Every 2 weeks they're full up and you wish they'd come round every week. Well, it's about to get worse. Oh, it started off with the lovely people in Welsh Wales. La da 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 da. Anyway, in Welsh Wales, furious families. You can see them all now running down Welsh Wales. Run the valley. We're running in the valley, the Welsh Wales. Furious families. Furious. Did you like that impression of being furious? Furious. I don't get furious very often. My mate gets furious very often. Oh, yes. In shops, on the phone. All the time he's suffering. It's like he looks for confrontation all the time. Absolutely. Whereas I usually just walk away. Or I say, yeah, all right, mate. And I go. I said, not interested. Not interested in having a row with anyone. Furious families say they've been forced to burn rubbish, offload it among pals, dispose of it at work and even dump it in the street because their council will only collect the bins once a month. Now, this is the thing. The main thing there I'm seeing is dump it. Dump it. Now, we've got a little bit of a problem around here now. Here in Bracknell, Royal Berkshire, because the local refuse site here, also known as The Tip, have started charging for various items. One of those items is plasterboard. And what they say is that builders are taking the mick, turning up with all this plasterboard and dumping it for nothing. Or perhaps giving it to I don't know, friends to take in card. I'm so sorry. My nose is really itching today. There's nothing up there. I'm just doing that to try and itch it. Oh, it's really annoying. Giving it to people's cars, giving it in, so that people in cars would take it down. And the councillors say the builders are taking the mic, and the only way they can do this is to start charging the builders to bring stuff like plasterboard. I don't know what else is on the list. Plasterboard is definitely on the list, right? But of course, people are now dumping it. I mean, this is the thing. If you're going to start charging people extra to have various items chucked away, they are going to dump it. We have, I often around here see gardening waste dumped. Now, to be honest, gardening waste, as long as it's plant material, maybe chopped up trees and that sort of thing, that's not too bad to dump, because it will go down, won't it? It will disintegrate. Not too bad. But still, this stuff is not dumped in the middle of the woods or something. It's dumped by the side of the road. And I've seen this time and time again. And a few years ago, the council did start charging to take away your garden refuse. Now, I do pay that. It's, I think, £40. I think it's gone up now. It's £40 a year. And for that, they come round every 2 weeks and empty my brown bin. My brown bin is where I put all my garden waste in. But other people, they don't want to pay that. They don't want to pay. So they just dump it somewhere. And I can see this getting worse right across the country as councils deem that they need to charge for this, that and the other. People are just going to dump the stuff. I mean, if I was to go and dump a lot, I mean, don't do DIY, as you well know. But if I was to go and dump a load of plasterboard somewhere, how do you know it's from me? How do they catch people? There's not cameras all over the countryside, is there, waiting to catch people like this? How stupid can you be to start charging people for various items? Ridiculous. Residents have been told of their misery under the scheme, which is set to be rolled out across the UK. Why? Because the council is now collecting rubbish not every 2 weeks, every 4 weeks. What are you supposed to do with 4 weeks' worth of rubbish? I mean, you'd have to put it in a little bag and take it into one of the bins in the street, wouldn't you? That's what I'd have to do. I couldn't just dump it. Disgusting people who dump their rubbish everywhere. And some of them are really stupid. You know, if you were going to dump your rubbish everywhere, wouldn't you remove the envelopes and bills with your names and addresses? No, they don't. They put it all in a bag. And of course, a council official goes, council opens the bag, and there's the proof that it's come from your house. I mean, as stupid as that is, but you can understand them dumping it. It says around 10,000 homes in Conway, North Wales, Wales, have been receiving visits from rubbish collectors every 4 weeks since September, when a year-long trial began. Many say they suffer foul smells. Oh, I don't like foul smells, do you? Especially if you go in a toilet after someone else has been in there. Oh, that's horrible. In a public toilet. And you go in and... Isn't that disgusting? And I haven't flushed the toilet! Oh, no! Many say they suffer foul smells as the rubbish rots outside their homes for weeks. One driver said their two children, 7 and 2, told the Daily Mail, it's ridiculous. I end up taking bags of waste and cardboard to work where we have a skip. That's how bad it's got. We also have a coal fire, so over Christmas, we were putting stuff on top of that to get rid of it. I mean, it's just ridiculous. It is absolutely ridiculous. excuse me, I'm losing my voice here. One bloke said there were 9 fly-tipping incidents on a 2-mile stretch of road. Here, look. In this constituency, in the first week of January alone, this is the Conservative bloke. Monthly pickups isn't the answer. It certainly isn't. It also likely to lead to adverse public health consequences and foul smells. Well, of course it would. 4 weeks is a long time for waste to be left, particularly in warmer weather. I mean, it's just so stupid. And you will find more and more of this, just stuff being dumped by the side of roads. I've been driving home on the motorway, and you find stuff on the motorway where they've just shoved it out the window. Bits of wood and glass and stuff like that. So stupid. And I'm sure it must cost councils more in the long run to go out and have to go and pick up this rubbish, which would, of course, be scattered. You know, you don't dump it and it stays like that. It starts getting scattered by foxes and other animals looking for something to eat. Whereas if you take it to the dump, it's all in one place, boop, gone. Ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Right, let's do some messages from yesterday's show, boys and girls. One moment, please. Where are we now? There we are. Joanna says, you should have your own quiz show. You already have your own show's jingle. Yes, indeed. I'd quite like to do Bob's Full House, that one. You remember that one? Bingo on the Beeb. Ba-da-ba-ba, 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 ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Bingo lingo, clickety-click. It's time to take your pick of the six. I remember the catchphrase. Bob Monkhouse, we love him. May God rest his soul. Tim says, many thanks for my birthday yesterday, but plans are out the window. He's woke up with flu. Achoo. Oh, no. Oh, come on, Tim. Is it really flu? Can you get out of bed, lovey? Are you sweating loads or are you just sneezing a little bit? I reckon you're sneezing a little bit, Timmy. You're sneezing a little bit, lovey. Joanna says, so sorry to hear. Oh, no, she's talking to Tim. Joanna's written back to Tim. You see what a lovely little family we have here. Oh, excuse me. Darren says, Amir Khan. We were talking about the Amir Khan porn video that has surfaced on the internet. And he says, you don't happen to have the link to the video for a friend of mine, of course. No, believe me, I've searched everywhere. I can't find it. I can't find it. And there's another one. There's some bloke on X Factor or some young lad, actually, on X Factor. He's got one. Oh, they're all at it, dear. They're all at it. So I'm afraid I can't find that link for you, Darren. I'm sure if you search far and hard enough, you will find it. Very, very hard. Yes. Simon says your quiz show could be Chris's Golden Wonder Shot due to your love of crisps. Oh, last night I had Doritos on the way home at the BP garage going, oh, no, it gets worse. They didn't have the small bag of Doritos. I had to buy the great big large one, which was £2.68. I thought, that's dear. And then I noticed the little label, £2 for £3. I had the whole one last night. When I got in from work last night, I had those and wild mushroom soup, which is absolutely delicious. Not good to go to bed with that, though, because every time I turned over, I could hear the soup and the cup of tea swishing around in my stomach. It was swishing around in my stomach. Blankety blank is probably what they'd pay you. On a serious note, Simon says, I think you would be very good at the bingo quiz that Bob Monkhouse did. Bob's Full House. Chris's Full House. I used to love that. But I think you would be good at any of them. I love the music to that, Bob's Full House. Shall I see if I can find it? Let's see if I can find the music to Bob's Full House. One moment, please. Bob's Full House theme. One moment, please. There it is. Here it is. Here it is. You ready? Bob's Full House intro. I love it. I love, and it's got the theme music at the end is just as good. It's slightly different at the end. Here we go. Here we go. 1984. My God, 1984 that was. 84, 94, 04, 14, 16, 17. That is 33 years old. I used to love, my mum loved that Bob's Full House as well. Let's do today's birthdays. We missed one out yesterday. I don't know how this happened, but the lovely Lord Dean Burr, and he's a real lord with the medals and a big house and several cars everywhere. Happy birthday to Lord Dean Burr, whose birthday it was yesterday. Sorry I missed you out yesterday, sir. I don't know why it didn't appear. And then I went on last night when I came in for work and you were there, so that was a bit odd. Happy birthday for yesterday, Lord Dean Burr. Happy birthday to Alan Russell, karaoke host, 47 years old today. Happy birthday, Alan. Happy birthday to my little friend, Ross Baker Hill, who's 26 years old today. He's a dad as well. Happy birthday to you, Ross. Happy birthday to LuLu Jones Power. Love your name. LuLu. Oh, you know you want to make me shout. Happy birthday to Gary G. Gelder. Happy birthday, Gary, 54. To Cara Cramphorn, 33. Is that you, Cara? It is, lovely Cara. Happy birthday, dear. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to Rockella Brown. And happy birthday to Maciek Pankowski. Now, where are you? You must be in Russia or somewhere like that, is it? Ah, Poland. Happy birthday to you as well. Here comes the song, and then we'll diss a bit. Long show today, wasn't it? Long show. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. Have a wonderful day, boys and girls, on your birthday, Thursday night. I'll be doing some DJing tonight at the Two Brewers in Clapham, starting at 10 o'clock and finishing at 2 a.m. Have a lovely day. Thanks so much for listening.